Time for a lovely ballad. This is one of Django's original compositions, Manoir de Reves, also known as Django's Castle. This is actually one of the tunes that was featured on the Mafia soundtrack. It's a game for the PS2 from the early 2000s that uses a lot of Django Reinhardt tunes as the sort of soundtrack. So you'd be driving around, bootlegging, racketeering, and there'd be some nice Django music playing while you do it. I wonder what Django thought about that. This lick, like a lot of the licks we've done on this channel, is going to be using a diminished arpeggio, really useful stuff. This is a really good example of how to use it. We're also going to touch upon Django's half bend technique, something that I don't hear enough of. I think it's a really good sound. In terms of the ratio of amount of work to learn them and amount of skill required to play the half bends, and the amount of return you get in terms of flavor and style, you get a lot of bang for your buck with this lick. It's a good value lick. So let's check it out. Okay, we're going to split it into two halves. Here's how the first half sounds. Here's how the second half sounds. So straight away, we're going straight into the diminished arpeggio. Now I'm going to show you the notes, and then I'm going to show you how Django's using it and what he's doing. Bear in mind, it starts on an A7, and then it resolves to a D major. So the first three notes are all on the E string. Let's start with the open string, then third fret, then sixth fret. Then two notes on the A string, the fourth fret, and then the seventh fret. Two notes on the D string, the fifth fret, and the 8th fret. One note on the G string, the 6th fret. And then one note on the B string, the 5th fret. Now that's the diminished arpeggio in this lick. So just to recap, here's how it goes. So once we've got there, then we need to resolve this to D major, and this is how Django does it. We're going to play four notes on the B string. First note is the 7th fret, and then it's going chromatically up, so one fret at a time, which means the next note will be on the 8th fret, and then the 9th fret, and then finally the 10th fret. And here we've resolved it now, because this is a chord tone of a D major. This is the 5th of D major. Very nice. So that's the first half of the lick. Let's see how it all sounds. Pretty cool. Let's look at the second half of the lick. Just a reminder, this is how it goes. So straight away, we're getting into one of those Django half bends. Really nice sound. Now, the note that he's wanting to play is this. That's the note you hear, but he wants to bend up to it. Instead of just playing it boring like that, he wants to bend up to it. So you find that note, and you go a fret down, and you bend up. And that is the first note of this second half of this lick. We're going to hit B string, 6th fret, and then bend up to it very nicely. Bear in mind that this is a half bend, which means it just bends up one fret. It's not a full bend like in rock or blues. This is just a little half bend. Very delicate, very nice. Now be sure to listen to the record for the timing of this, because Django plays what we call rubato, which means it's sort of slightly out of time. It's kind of a free time thing. It sounds really romantic, and Django's an absolute master of it. Sounds good, but the trouble is it's pretty hard to copy, so you're going to have to listen to the record really closely on this one. Now, I'll teach you the rest of the lick, and then we'll talk a little bit more about half bends. So once we've got this, we're going to do one note on the B string, the 5th fret, then one note on the G string, the 7th fret, one note on the D string, 8th fret, back up to the G string, 7th fret, and then three notes on the D string, all 7th fret. 1, 2, 3. Very nice. Let's hear how the whole thing sounds together. So this diminished arpeggio, Django's just ran up it, and then when he needs to change chord and find a chord tone, he just finds a kind of the nearest one, really, and just lands on it. These diminished arpeggios, you can run up and down them as long as you know where to start. That's the trick. So if we're going over a dominant chord, in this case it was an A7, you can start on either the fifth of the dominant chord, the dominant 7, the flat 9, or as I like to think of it, one fret above the root, because I'm a guitar player and this is how I think, or you can start on the third of the A7 chord. So you can start from any of those. You can start from the fifth, start from the seventh, the third, or the flat 9, I should say, or the third. And all you do, you just run up, and then when you want to resolve to the D chord, the one chord, you just find the nearest chord tone. So let's say I've gone, and then I think I want to resolve now. Well, I can either just find this one here, or I can go there to the one. I just find any chord, any note from that D major. Let's say I'm going to start from the flat 9. Just pick one at random. Flat 9, or one fret above the root, as I like to think. All the way up there, and I think I need to resolve now. Just find the nearest D chord tone, which is probably here, the fifth. So that's what Django does in that lick, and that's a simple way to use a diminished arpeggio over a dominant chord going to a one chord. Cool. Now then, half bends, they sound really cool. In theory, you can bend up to any note in a half bend, but some will sound better than others, some more in the style than others. Now, in my experience, and this really is just my personal take on it, I think the notes that sound best are either the fifth, the sixth, or the ninth. So let's say we're in A major, and you're playing over an A major chord. Finding your fifth, your sixth, and your ninth, and doing little bends up to there sounds pretty cool. I'll give you a very quick demonstration of each one. So here's how the fifth sounds. That's the fifth. Let's hear the sixth. One, two, three, four. Not bad. Now we'll hear the ninth. It's probably my favourite one. One, two, three, four. Pretty cool. So try those out. Experiment with them. Bear in mind, the fifth, sixth, and the ninth, they also work over a minor chord as well, so be sure to try that out in your own time. Guys, thanks a lot for tuning in. That was loads of fun. I really hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please hit the like button, please hit the subscribe button, share it with your friends. We've got loads more lessons coming up. We've also got a cool podcast that we do, the Gypsy Jazz Hangouts Podcast. You can hear that on Spotify, it's on YouTube, it's all over the place. So be sure to check that out, share it with your friends, and we'll see you for the next one. Cheers.